For 14 years, Amy Bright waited in exam rooms trying to figure out what was causing her constant back and leg pain. It wasn't until she saw this image that she realized it was a needle lodged in her spine.
Absolutely wrong what they did to me.
Amy Bright doesn't mince words describing the damage she says she endured at the hands of Naval Hospital Jacksonville.
Every year it's worse. Every single year it just gets worse and worse.
September 5th, 2003 was filled with joy. Bright gave birth to a son, Jacob, the youngest of six kids in her blended family. But pain started immediately after and hasn't stopped in the 14 years since.
It feels like fire, like a poker. It next to my tailbone. And then on occasion, it shoots down the left side of my leg on my calf, and then down and then into my foot.
Bright and her family have since resettled in Texas, and that's where she got this CT scan 4 months ago, revealing the 3-centimeter needle lodged in her spine.
Across the spinal canal and into her spine. I'm speechless that this was not disclosed to this woman.
Jacksonville attorney Sean Cronin, together with Bright, filed a claim against the federal government Thursday alleging medical malpractice, fraud, and negligent concealment by the staff at Naval Hospital Jacksonville. They say the needle caused permanent nerve damage.
It's documented in her medical records that they had an unsuccessful spinal needle attempt at Naval Hospital Jacksonville in September of 2003. So no one else put a needle in her back.
Both Cronin and Bright claim hospital staff never told Bright the needle lodged and broke in her spine, and it was never written in her medical records. So for 14 years, Bright was misdiagnosed, never suspecting it could be remnants of a C-section more than a decade ago.
If they were any kind of human whatsoever, they would have said, "Hey, I'm sorry, I made a huge mistake, let's fix it."
Bright says the pain is expected to worsen over time, and she'll likely have to live the rest of her life with the needle in place.
Now that a claim is filed, the government has 6 months to respond. If a settlement is not reached, then a lawsuit will be filed. Juliette Dreyer, First Coast News on your side.